We've all got it. There are horoscopes, diets, and even dating services based on blood groups. But when it comes to the facts about blood, how much do most of us really know? Let's find out, shall we? Now, our blood is made of different parts. One part is the red blood cells that carry oxygen around our bodies. They also carry special proteins on their surfaces. Now, what might they be called?
Why, they're called antigens!
Thank you, red blood cell. Antigens come in two types, type A and type B. This is what determines your blood type. If you have both antigens, your blood is type AB. But what do antigens do?
Antigens can cause your immune system to react.
That's right. Because your immune system rejects anything it doesn't recognize. The antibodies of type A patients will attack anything that's got the B antigen in it, and vice versa. No such worries for people with AB blood. They have both types of antigens, so get on just fine with A and B blood. About 38% of people in the UK have type A blood. 10% have type B, and 3% have type AB. The other 49% have neither antigen. We call that type O. It's easy to remember that O has neither antigen because O looks like zero. That gives us the letters ABO. The ABO test is how we determine blood types using a blood sample to see how the antigens and antibodies react. But what does that mean for blood transfusions? Well, type A blood can be received by patients who are type A or AB. And type B blood is good for types B and AB. But AB type blood is only given to AB patients.
But what about all those type O people?
The good news is that almost everyone can receive type O blood because it carries no A or B antigens. So you O types are a useful bunch. However, it's trickier to receive blood if you're type O. You will have both anti-A and anti-B antibodies in your blood, which will attack AB or AB blood. So you can only receive type O blood. But what if somebody is given the wrong type of blood? It's very serious if patients receive the wrong blood type, so hospitals have stringent processes to make sure this doesn't happen. So, all you O donors are really important. You can give blood safely to almost anyone. But oh dear, it's the end of the show. Tune in next time to find out about the importance of positive and negative blood types.